So what are general objectives? So general objectives are actually the main goal of the research. It's sort of like the mission and vision of your study. So it is basically stated in terms that encompasses all activities of the research. And in some cases, you may actually have two or more general objectives, no? Especially if you have like several studies under one umbrella major study. Specific objectives, on the other hand, are goals to achieve your general objective. So they actually describe fixed actions, and they're basically stated as a list under your general objective. So if you have a two or more general objectives, so for general objective number one, you can have several specific objectives there. And then for general objective number two, you can have another list of specific objectives under general objective number two. No? So how do you write out your specific objectives? You actually expound on the details of the goals of your general objective. So for example, no? But you always start out with your research question and then you convert your research question to a statement. For example, will proning help my patient with COVID-19? No? So you prone the patient. I'm sure you do that. So will proning help my patients with COVID-19? And then what you did with what Dr. Siriban told you, so you started searching for literature and you found out, oh yeah, mukhang the literature is not really very clear yet, so I want to write a study on this. So you convert your research question into a statement to determine the effect of proning on patients with COVID-19. No? So basically, the general objective is to determine the effect of proning on patients with COVID-19. However, we have one problem there. When you talk about effect, what do you actually mean? Diba? Let's go back to SMART. Is this specific? No, it's not. No, kasi the term effect, is it measurable? You don't know how to measure effect. No, is it achievable? Probably, if you do your study, you can see the effect of that. Diba? So is it realistic? It is. It is relevant, of course, especially during our time. And is it time-bound? We don't know yet because it's not stated in the general objective. No? So we make our objectives smarter by writing in the specific objectives, for example, to determine and compare oxygen saturation levels. So the oxygen saturation levels, so that is a specific and measurable, as well as it's more time-bound and relevant for our research, no? The other thing, other outcome, other variable that we want is to determine and compare mortality rates among COVID-19 patients in the ICU who underwent proning to those who didn't, no? So mortality rate, it's measurable. Of course, you can see it, they die or they live, diba? And then it's very time-bound because you know you'll stop monitoring when the patient dies and you'll stop monitoring when the patient leaves the ICU and lives, diba? So this way, you end up having SMART objectives already. So when you write out your research objectives, you always start out with an infinitive verb. Describe a unique case of, or to illustrate the theory on, or in a prevalent study, to collect samples of, and then in hypothesis testing type of studies, in intervention, you want to compare groups. And then in other studies, like in case control, where you want to see if there is an association between two factors, you can try to establish or to correlate. No? So these are examples to start out your research objectives. Then after you decide on what you want to do, so that's the pinaka direct way of telling people what you want to do, you follow it up with the variables and the population. For example, to determine the effect of an experimental drug, TTN-433, on blood pressure control among the elderly population. To compare mean arterial blood pressure among elderly receiving TTN-433 plus standard care and those receiving standard care alone. No, so in this particular research objective, it's very clear what you want to do, which is to determine or to compare what you're going to measure, which is blood pressure control or mean arterial blood pressure monitoring. It's specific on the population, which is the elderly, very measurable because of the blood pressure. And then it's very time-bound because you're going to see whether you have good control or not, no? So that's how you write your research objective. Now, one of the things that we make a big mistake on when we start out to write your objectives is that we forget that our outcomes are not quantifiable. Our earlier example on compliance, no? We talked about compliance to medication. What if we want to talk about compliance of the hospital? Then we have the ISO audit tools. Or what if we say we want to see the effect of perampanel on improving seizure control? So what do we actually mean by improving seizure control? How are you going to measure that? No? So for example, you measure it by responder rate. So how many patients who took the medication had a 50% reduction in seizures as compared to those who didn't take the medication. No? So how do you operationalize these? No? You operationalize this by writing down in your definition of terms in your study. But when you write it down in your objectives, you already say to determine responder rates in the perampanel group as compared to the non-perampanel group. So after writing your objectives, so you listed them down now. So you reassess the following. So first and foremost, are these the outcomes or variables that are relevant? So how do you know that they are relevant? On top of first looking at your own practice, looking at your own surroundings, are these relevant to us? Are these relevant to my society? Are these relevant to my institution? You also ask other people, do you think this is okay now? Do you think that these are the important variables that I have to measure? So the next thing is you have to determine, are these objectives within the scope of your general objective? So sometimes we tend to forget, like for example, no? If you, let's say, want a study on making a database, just a database on people who had stroke and hypertension within 1 year of each other. So a database would be sort of like a registry. You just list down how many people, maybe get their age, their sex, and that's it, and where they're coming from. Very basic, sort of like a census. So your objective is just that. And then when you present it, somebody would say, oh, why don't you add in treatment outcome? What about the medicines that were given to him? What about his maintenance medicine? So that would be beyond the scope of your objective already. You can just say, I'm just developing a database. I'm not into the outcomes. I'm not into the treatment effects. So it's just basically the database. So you have to look again if it's within the scope of your general objective. When you review and you find out na, I think I want something more, then you can always revise your objectives. You can either add another general objective or you just revise all your specific objectives. And of course, finally, are your objectives SMART? When you write down and you look at your objectives, you look at them as a whole because you do not have to write every statement as SMART. Yung tipong, it's specific, it's measurable, it's achievable, it's relevant, and it's time-bound. Na within 3 months, within 4 months. No, you don't have to write that. You look at it as a whole. You can write that in the general objectives, mentioning the time-bound or the time frame, and then it's not written anymore in the specific objective. But as a whole, when people read your objectives, both general and specific, you want them to say na, oh, Dr. so-and-so made smart objectives talaga.